Most people have seen the powered paraglider flying videos on YouTube, and they're a dime a dozen. I have had a number of people ask me, though, how do you set up your equipment? And some of the more, logistical aspects of it. And so I thought I'd put a quick video together just to let you know how I go about deciding whether I'm going to fly on a particular day. And how to set up the equipment. So one thing you want to do is see how the winds are going to be at ground level for your takeoff and your landing. And this is one of the first things you want to check if you think it's a good day for flying, is to check the winds.
There's another website that I like for checking the winds. And if I move to Sunday at 8 o'clock, everything is nice and blue, which means it's calm
The
in
nice
my
thing about this
area.
website is
You can look at the time, 6 o'clock in the evening, and it'll show you different wind speeds at different altitudes. So if you want to see how the winds are going to be at 528 feet at 6 o'clock, you just move over and it tells you 7 miles per hour. And then also the direction that the winds are coming from.
Once you've checked the weather and it looks like it's a good evening for flying, then you want to set up your equipment. In my case, I use a cart, a four-wheel cart, which you can see right here. Of course, it's got the motor and propeller in the back. Let me give you a little bit better look at that. It's a two-stroke engine with a 2.5 gallon gas tank. I use aviation fuel for mine. It's a little bit more reliable, and it doesn't, the gas doesn't go bad like regular auto gas does. A couple additives to it. Of course, you have to add the oil. I also add a lead scavenger to keep the engine nice and clean as much as I can. Okay, so next you want to warm up the engine. Make sure the engine's running smoothly and that there's no problems that you can determine prior to actually flying. So next, you want to get your wing set up. I keep mine in the garage in a 99-gallon container with no sharp edges on the inside. Because you're a chute, of course, you don't want to have any tears in it, although it is pretty tough. Try to keep all these lines from getting tangled up. When I set the chute back in at the end of a flight, I kind of, wrap things around so it's more or less in an untangled
state.
I've got the
chute
kind of in a big wad back behind with my lines coming over, and eventually they'll attach to the quad or the cart. So what you want to do first is kind of spread out your wing, as we call it, and try to make sure these lines are untangled. That's the
Now I
next
have
step.
the wing kind of stretched out, and the lines on the one side are in pretty good shape. Of course, this side, we've got to pull these and try to ensure that they're untangled as much as possible.
Okay, so it took me about 5 minutes to get these things untangled. I first did the red, making sure they were detangled, and then the bright green, and then the blue, and then the purple. The purple is the furthest back on the wing. So when the wing comes up, the purple lines are going to be in the back, and the red lines are going to be in the front. That has to be pretty much detangled, and then we do the same thing with the other side. You attach this to the cart, make sure the lines are untangled. Once you do that, again, you want to make sure that your wing back behind is pretty well centered with your cart, and that the winds are going in that direction so that you're flying this way into the wind. So it's not perfectly set up right now, but you get the idea. And as you take off and move forward with the cart, the wing behind you will catch the air and start to fly up over the top. And Once it gets overhead, you need to make sure it's stable and not oscillating back and forth. And once it is stable, you hit the throttle, the accelerator, and engine revs up. You go faster, and before you know it, you're lifting off the ground and flying. And so I'll show you that next.